Hello guys, welcome to Adota Farm. In today's video, I have a lot to discuss with you guys today. And today's topic will be based on chicken versus fish versus catfish, which one is more lucrative? Poultry bed versus catfish farming, which one is more lucrative? You know, in times like this, or if you bring any topics like this, before you tell people the one that is lucrative or the one that is profitable, you must first of all try in as much as possible to break them down what the both is. And I know you guys might have different definitions for this catfish farming and poultry farming. Catfish farming is a type of farming system whereby you go for it and you rear it for consumption purpose or for commercial purpose. It's just a type of agriculture and aquaculture, they call it aquaculture, whereby you raise fish for consumption purpose or for the purpose of commercial purpose. Why for poultry bed is a raising of bed or is a rearing of bed for commercial purpose or for consumption purpose as well. You know, the both work hand in hand. You are raising them or you are rearing them, you are keeping them for you to sell, to make profit from it. Is either you are eating it as a family, you are doing it just in a smaller scale whereby you and your family will consume it, or you are doing it in a larger scale whereby you will sell it out for people that has interest in it. And not just because you want to make profit from meat, that was the reason why you're selling it, no. But it's because of the nutrients that each of these livestock possess, because of the benefit it gives to our body. That was the reason why you are selling it, or that was the reason why you are doing it for consumption purpose or for commercial purpose. So let me just end that that area there. So like I said, today's video will be based on which one is more profitable in terms of if you want to go into it, which one is more profitable. Okay, first of all, before you talk about the profitability of any business, what you need to check out or what you need to watch out for is the locations. It matters a lot, and in most of my videos I normally tell you guys that before you go into any business, what you first of all watch out for is your location, where you are staying, the environment. It matters a lot. You can't start up these two farming in a place whereby it doesn't have when you want to sell that product, it's very difficult for you. Or you can't just start up that farm in a place whereby it's not accessible for people to come to check what you are doing or to purchase what you want to sell. It's not okay. So locations matters a lot, and these are the number one step that I want you guys to know before starting up anyone, or before you would discover or think of choosing the one that is best or the one that is lucrative. So you must have it in mind, locations matters a lot. And second thing is on your land. These two type of farming, it requires land. Although in terms of catfish farming, you can do it in such a way whereby you can do a concrete pond or a trampoline pond, and by that though you don't really need to buy land before starting up it. Why for poultry you need to buy land? Probably if you are not doing it on a battery case system stuff or like a smaller way, but you still need to buy land because you can't do a poultry around an environment. You need to do it in such a way that the poultry farm will be far from your environment, from the town or from the city. It will be far from it. The reason why the farm must be far away from house is because of the smell of poultry. You can't do it around. So in such a way whereby the land that you're going to purchase must be a place that is accessible as well. In as much as the land is far from the town or from the city, the land must also be accessible whereby you can go there easily, you can market your product easily. The land must be closer to a market whereby whenever you want to sell your chickens or your broiler, your the eggs, the day old chicks or anyone, you know, it must be accessible for people. It must be closer to market so it will be easy for you to get across easily. So those two steps matters a lot. Number one, your location. Two, the land. And the place whereby you want to buy your land matters a lot, like I said. So right now I'm just going to go into the full details about poultry bed and catfish farming, which one is more lucrative. If we take a very good look at it, we will need to talk about cost as well. starting up the boat farm, we need to talk about the cost of starting up the boat farm. Let me just say that is my number three point. So starting up the boat farm, the required amount, let me just give you a rough estimate. I'm not giving you a correct estimate right now. We are just talking about the rough estimate. The rough estimate of starting up a chicken farm, let's talk about layers, for instance, is way higher compared to catfish farming. Because if you want to start up this farm, you will need to build. You need to construct a very good house for the layers. And starting up this house or constructing this house, you'll be preparing up to like 8 million naira, 8 to 10 million naira before building, you know, the section whereby they will, you start feeding them to when they are ready to lay egg. You know, building, you know, for the cement you buy, the blocks, the stone, everything, the gravel, everything that you use for the building of the house, the workmanship for the people, you know, it will be costing you about 8 million or 6 million naira thereabout. That is apart from the feeding aspect of the chickens, apart from the feeding aspect, or apart from purchasing the chicken itself. Can you see that one is way higher than the catfish? And you know, you are going to raise them to whereby they were 18 weeks, 25 on weeks, or 18 to 25 weeks before the egg is done, before the chickens will start laying egg, before you can start getting the money that you use to start up this process. Can you see that it's way higher? Now let's talk about the catfish pond. So catfish, let us say approximately, or the rough estimate on amount that you can use to start up a catfish farming, let us say it's up to 3M. The reason I'm saying it's up to 3M because probably if you want to do an electric pond or if you want to do a concrete pond, you still need to buy all those cement, you know, blocks before they will start up this stuff. And even though if it's a trampoline, you still need to buy it before they will start up this particular set of farm or set of house for you. So let's say you prepare to like 3M. I'm just giving a rough estimate. It might not be up to that and it might be more than that, but at least if the price is kind of high, it should not be more than 4M to start up the farm. And that's if you are starting in a larger number. That's for the catfish. But apart from buying the catfish, the price of getting the fingerlings or the juvenile size is not there. But let me just I'm just giving you guys the estimate that you can use to start up or to build up the farm. Can you see that it's kind of reduced more than poultry bed? So for people that are looking for something way cheaper than poultry, you can go for catfish. And why you are looking for a long time stuff, you know, you can go for poultry. Because poultry will later benefit you. That if you take care of them very well. And you know, like I said, the amount or the budget that you use to start up this farm is way higher compared to the catfish area. For white catfish, the amount to start up the farm is very low compared to layers or compared to starting up any poultry bed. So for people that ask different questions concerning poultry and catfish farming, which one is more lucrative? I think with these few points, you should know the one that is kind of lucrative to go into, or kind of cheaper to go into. Let's just use that lucrative. That lucrative word is just that the both are profitable, but the one that is kind of cheaper to start is catfish. The both will actually pay you, that if you manage them very well. So like we've talked about the cost of starting the both farming already. And the third thing is the feeding aspect. That is the fourth step that I'll be giving you guys today, is the feeding aspect. Feeding on 1,000 beds is more higher than feeding 1,000 catfish. You know, the price of feed right now is kind of high. So feeding a 1,000 bed will be way higher compared to feeding a 1,000 catfish. Because if you are buying a tough feed, for example, if you are getting a layers and you are buying a tough feed, you know, buying a tough feed right now, I didn't know the current price of the bag, and you know it's just a 15 kg. You buy more of it on when they were starter. You buy starter from starter, you buy finisher as well when they'll start laying egg. That is a merge feed, the grower. You start buying the grower feed. So you know that at the end of the day, if you calculate the money that you spent in feeding a 1,000 birds, it will be more higher than feeding 1,000 catfish. And like I said, your bird will reach 18 to 25 weeks before start laying egg. That apart from the vaccinations that you give to the bird, apart from that treatment that you give to the bird as well. But why for catfish, you know, when you get in at the juvenile size, you start with 0.1, you know, feed, size of feed, you get to 1.5, you get to 2M. Then when your fish are 2 months, you can change to local feed. And that local feed, you can probably go for sink feed or floating feed. If you didn't have money for floating feed, you go for sink feed. And sink feed will be kind of cheaper than floating feed. You see that, that if you raise a 1,000 catfish, the amount that you spend, it will be kind of cheaper compared to raising 1,000 birds. But in terms of when you talk about the longevity of the business, or when you talk about probably if you want on a farm or a type of business that you do for a very long time, then you can choose poultry rather than choosing catfish. But if you are looking for a short time business or a short time livestock farming to go into, then you can go for catfish. And those are the two common business that are trending in Nigeria currently right now. Because if you watch most of the videos on the internet, you will see people talking about catfish, see people talking about birds. And last, the few weeks ago that we spent this Christmas, you know, I buy broiler, or I bought broiler rather, and I told you guys that one broiler costs almost on 7,500 naira for one. So let's now calculate, if you buy a broiler of 7,000 naira, or let's just say, okay, you buy that broiler at the rate of 1,500 naira when the broiler is 1 month old, you buy it and you raise them for 4 months. Now, if you calculate all the expenses of the feed you might have given to the broiler until that broiler reached that 4 months, calculate it with that 7,500 naira that you are selling that broiler, you can see that at the end of the day, you are not making any profit in broiler farming. And that is what people are not watching. That is what people are not on watch out for in all those poultry farming of the thing. I'm not saying it's not profitable, and I'm not saying it's not good for you to invest into on a poultry farm, but I'm just trying to give you the estimates, or trying to give you the things that you just need to watch out for, or things that you need to know before going into this boat farming. The boat farming are lucrative, and they are the common farming that people are going into, apart from other livestock like the piggery, the goatry, and the grass cut of a thing. Apart from those type of farm, the common farming system that people are going into is poultry bird and catfish farming. They are the most trend business that people are doing right now. So can you see that the amount of you starting up a poultry farm is way higher compared to a catfish farming. But still yet, at the same time, people are still complaining that they are not making profit for catfish farming. So if you are not making profit for catfish farming, then that means you didn't put all the step into consideration, or probably your preparation, or how you treat or how you feed your fish are not okay, or the type of feed you give to your fish, or your location as well. If you are living in a place whereby catfish are not moving very well, then you go into poultry. And if you are living in a place whereby you see that, okay, people are consuming catfish more than poultry, why don't you go for catfish rather than going for poultry? So the boats are profitable. But with these few points, I think you should know the one that is profitable, or the one that is cheaper to start. And as a beginner, before going into any business, you must sit down, strategize, think, you know, Google, find different information concerning that business before you invest your money, so that at the end of the day, you will know what you are going to make out of it. So between poultry and cattle farming, the profitable one, I think with these few points, you should know the one that is kind of profitable. And why for catfish farming, 1 kg of catfish right now is about, here in Ibadan, I'm not talking about some other state. I didn't know about the price that they're selling the 1 kg of catfish in some other state. But here in Ibadan, 1 kg of catfish is 830 naira. 1 kg of catfish is 830 naira. And if you feed your catfish very well, your catfish can weigh up to 1.5 kg to 2 kg within 4 to 5 months. Although it depends on the type, you know, in catfish farming, we have just 3 types or 3 categories of catfish. We have the Claras, we have the Heterobancus, and we have the Hybrid. Those are the 3 classes, or those are the on three breed of catfish that we have, that people go into it that much. And on the results of Clara's and Enterobranquis is what gave us an hybrid. So whichever one that I want to go for, hybrid will last long, because if you rear hybrid, you can rear hybrid to like 7 to 8 months before you set them out. And a fish that you rear 7 to 8 months can weigh up to 2, 4, 3 kg. Why for Claras, within 4 months, 5 months, you can sell them out and they can still weigh up to 1 kg on 600 grams or above that, depending on the type of feed you give to them. So can you see that within a short period of time, you can start making money from catfish farming than poultry farming. Poultry farming is a long time stuff. At the end of the day, you will make your profit. And let's talk about their disease and as well. In catfish farming, it will be very real before you sell your fish dying. That's if you didn't buy the fish from the right place. But if you get the fish from the right place, your fish will survive. I mean, the high chances of them on getting ill or any disease to happen to your fish is very low compared to poultry bed. In poultry farming, they are prone to disease a lot. Before you know, probably if a Newcastle disease happens to occur in your farm, you can lose almost your chickens at the same time or within an hour, you can lose almost all your chickens. So can you see that in times of disease of a thing, catfish is at a safer side than poultry. So those are things that I want you guys to watch out for or to learn before you go into this type of farming or before you choose one above the other. So with this few points of mind, I think you guys should know that catfish farming and poultry farming, they are both lucrative, but in terms of on setup, locations and everything, catfish, their setup is very low compared to poultry. But if you are looking for a long time stuff farming, go for poultry. If you are looking for a short time stuff, go for catfish. So catfish. So please, if you have more information to ask me concerning these two on livestock farming, you can drop your message. At the end of this video, I'll be dropping my contact list. You can add me up on WhatsApp, you can message me, and I'll teach you more area that you need to know. And the one that is profitable, that is lucrative. And I think with these videos already, you should know that the one that is profitable and the one that is okay. And please, if you want us to start on to set up this type of farm for you in any state that you're living, please do want to reach out to us. You can come and we'll start up the farm for you. And please, if you are new in our channel, don't forget to subscribe. Turn the notification bell to be notified when next we drop a new video like this for you. Kindly like this video and keep on sharing this video. Bye for now.